Hi everyone, welcome to Stunner Share. So today I'll be covering the Nifty and the Bank Nifty post market analysis, and it's not like an usual analysis what I wanted to do. There was a question from one of my friends asking like how to know whether a pullback is a buying opportunity, or how to know like how we will be getting a confirmation to do a trade. So these were the questions he was asking. So I thought of explain. He also told that explain with Nifty as a case study so that it will be helpful for him. So that is why I thought of doing it today. So along with this, I'll cover Nifty, Bank Nifty, and as well as the Bajaj Auto, which I shared yesterday in the video, and today how it has performed. We will see that. And if time permits, we will also see the gap up stocks and gap down stocks, which has happened today and what has happened for that. And Tata Steel also, I just told, gave an update in the channel. We'll be covering that also. So coming to Nifty, these were the levels I shared yesterday for today. These were the levels I shared on 19th of November, stating that 20th of November, these levels can be respected. So what I mentioned in the first point is like, if price closes above 12,830, then any pullback is a buying opportunity. But this is the line 12,830. And what happened is like the candle only faced rejection. It did not give a close above 12,830. And after that, what happened is like, you need to go for the second point. As per the second point, what it has told is like, if the price is close between 12,700 to 12,830, then you have to wait and watch for the candlestick pattern to check for reversals for a trade. So either if suppose you are going to short it over here, you have to trail your stop loss, or if you find a reversal over here like this, then you need to go for a buy side. And then finally, after that, what has happened is like Nifty has, what I mentioned is that Nifty has to close below 12,700 to give a sell side. But unfortunately, today it did not close below 12,700, and we did not get a selling opportunity at all. But after the second half, it got a close about 12,830. So any pullback is a buying opportunity. So if you're going to go for a trade after a close, then you need to be very cautious, because after a breakout, I always wait for a retest. So only after a retest, you better go for an entry. So this is the Nifty analysis as per the levels I have shared yesterday. Now let's see with respect to CPR on what has happened. Okay guys, so this is the CPR. Fine. So what the CPR states that is, this CPR tells that it is a lower value CPR. Okay, this is a lower value CPR. So whenever a lower value CPR occurs, so you need to wait and watch for a rejection at the CPR to know what to do. So first of all, let me go by one step the other. So it is a two-day relationship is called as a for lower value CPR. So that means the momentum is bearish. So the second step, what you need to do is like, where does the candle open? So the candle has opened exactly at the CPR. So as per the CPR trick, what will happen is like the candle might move towards S1, or the candle might move towards R1, or entire day it will remain range bound within the CPR. So this is what the candle CPR tricks with respect to opening candle print. Now first point is like lower value, second point is like where the candles has opened. So we have now the third point is like, now you need to understand whether the lower value relationship of bearishness is accepted or rejected. So in this case, the lower value relationship is neither accepted nor rejected, because the candle opened exactly at CPR. It is like a midpoint. So we were not able to decide whether it has got accepted or rejected. So what you can do is like, you need to forget about CPR and the you need to forget CPR for a time being, because once you have to apply a proper price action theory over here. So what you need to do is like, you need to wait and watch for any reversal. So first of all, there are certain doji candles or indecisive candles over here. So retailers or a novice traders, they will not be able to decide what will happen over here. So what you can do is like, you can better leave it as such and wait for the next support zone, and you have to check what will happen at that support zone. So this is the support zone. So this support zone is nothing but the previous day low. So now you need to see what will happen at this zone. So till this candle, it did not give a close. This candle gave a break at previous day low, but did not give a close below the previous day low. So what you can do is like, you can wait for a follow-up candle, and after that candle, you can go for an entry, keeping the low as the stop loss. So by this, you would have easily encountered a reversal trade, and you would have got some good profit. But the thing is like, see, holding the trade actually matters. You found a reversal over here, and I am damn sure that no one will be taking an entry till this point. Why? because there are two other doji candles over here. So initially people will be of very much scary or very much fear that the loss may be more and all those things. But what I would personally say to you guys is, like, if you guys wanted to learn price action, if you guys wanted to trade without fear, I would request each and everyone to go to stocks. Why? Because it's like in stocks, you can trade with n number of quantities. You can go with one and you can go with 1,000. But in the case of Nifty, you need to go with the lot size, either in options or in futures. If you're going with options, there is a problem of time decay also. And one more thing, what you need to know is, like, the CPR is a bit wide. So you have to expect a narrow range bound day. So whenever you're expecting a narrow range bound day, is this better to avoid the particular day? Yes. Then what else? Okay, so if in case you someone has entered a trade over here above this candle, fine, and this candle's low is going to be the stop loss, so you need to enter a trade and you have to trail it. Fine, you can trail it or you can fix your target. Like, okay, if suppose the CPR is touched, we will exit the trade. So you need to fix a target, like how and where, and that is where you will be able to sustain. If you are, like, for example, some people place with multiple lots. So what they can do is, like, if suppose they are going to buy here with some, assume 10 lots, and if suppose the CPR is touched, they can book the 5 lots over here and they can place the stop loss at the cost for 5 lots. Anyways, it is going to get hit. So riding this trend from here to here, I don't think so. None would have done it because the CPR is also wide and passing the CPR is also tough. So it is basically, it is a better to avoid trade. So this is what the explanation or the, this is what the analysis, what I can do with Nifty. And you guys, I'll not cover Bank Nifty. You guys can check Bank Nifty on the levels, what has happened and how you have to act upon. So that will be helping you guys. Now let's move on to see what happened to Bajaj Auto. Bajaj Auto is one such stock which I discussed in the yesterday's video, and I've also clearly showed that video also. So according to the chart, whatever I have drawn, you guys can check the previous video, try to tag the video here. So what happened is, over here is, like, I was able to see this pattern, so I was waiting for a breakout, and I finally today it gave a breakout and it blasted till 3025. Now what will happen is, like, it came for a retest and it has taken a retest over here. Fine. So now now you guys know I am taking a position. I have taken a position at 3044 in Bajaj Auto. So what will happen to me is, like, till now the SL what I have placed is 3003. Clear? Because after this, for now, I took the position at around 13th or 14th. And from the day it has formed a low of 2996. So I kept a SL of nearly this zone. This is the zone which gave a breakout. So this is a zone which I kept a stop loss. But now then, after I see a pattern forming, I just kept a stop loss over here. Then I'm trying to trail over here and here. Finally, my stop loss is over 3003. So now my better stop loss will be this low of 3036. But anyways, I'll wait for the candle's nature, how it is performing and all those things. And then only I'll be deciding the trade. So as I have entered already, so my concept of placing a stop loss, placing a trail SL will be different. So please do the same analysis from your side. Now let's see what happened to Tata Steel. Tata Steel is one stock which I gave you guys saying, like, some theory on it. So let's see what has happened to that. So if you guys see over here, I can take the chart. Okay, so Tata Steel in radar for buy, will wait for high to break, check for price action. And then what I have told over here is, like, if you guys see, this black line is going to be the previous day high and it faced some resistance at the previous day high, and still current day low is not broken. Check the video posted today morning and decide what can be done. So guys, check the video and what can be done. And one hint what I gave is, like, as it has faced the resistance as previous day high, but still what I told is, like, if it is going to break this candle's high, I'll be taking an entry. So that is what I have told over here. Tata Steel in radar for buy, will wait for high to break, check for price action. So why did I say that? See, there is a rejection at previous day high, but still I did not go for a short. It has even broken the low of the candle, but still I did not go for a short. So why? So that is the question I would have expected from you people, so that will help me, like, to encourage more or to share a lot of knowledge. Because in yesterday's video, I told, like, for a gap up and gap down, so check for the resistance and support and accordingly act upon. But here, even though it faced a resistance at previous day high, but I did not go for a short. Rather than I said, if it is going to break the high, I'll be going for a buy. So you guys should have thought about it, but I'm not sure how many people have thought about it. So basically, my point was like, this is an higher value CPR and 2 days, it is very bit narrow. So my expectation was like, it is going to be a pullback for a buying opportunity. So there are n number of scenarios which you can see. It's not that only CPR, but if you see Tata Steel, which is in an uptrend, it is not in a downtrend. It is not giving any correction also. So if I move into day chart, if you guys see over here, it is in an uptrend. From a downtrend, it is forming an uptrend. So basically, I won't short this sort of stock until and unless the previous day low is getting broken. So only if the previous day low is going to get broken, and then only I'll be taking a short. Otherwise, I'll not be going for a short. So try, I have shared the analysis. I have shared as much as content in the previous video, but try to apply and see what has happened and what will happen and what is happening in the stock. And then coming to the gap up and gap down stocks, there were only a few stocks which I noticed in the morning, and I thought some people would be able to trade, or some people would ask some questions, but I don't get any questions at all. Until and unless I don't get a question, I'm very happy. So in the downside, like in a gap downside, there is not much, so we'll avoid that. And in gap upside also, I told that more than 2% expected, but nothing, it was like 2% more. So I'm taking only Power Grid. So let's see what happened to Power Grid. So this is the Power Grid chart. So the opening of the candle is over here. And after the opening of the candle completely filled the gap. And after that, it traded entirely inside the 15 minutes high and 15 minutes low. And I think CPR also gave a good support. So only one stock came in a gap up, but still I won't consider, because I always save for a 2% more, but here not a case. So 1.97% gap up with Power Grid, and it ultimately remained range bound. So that's it from my end, guys. So I have tried to explain as much as content from you guys, for you guys. So if you guys feel the content is really useful, try to share your comments, like share your feedback, and try to like the video. If you feel the knowledge you should share to others, kindly do a share. And if you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section, or mail me to stunnershare@gmail.com, or you can also contact me in Telegram. So you guys will be helpful. You guys will be able to get some knowledge out of it. So that's it from my end. Thanks a lot. Stay tuned for more videos.